Hello guys, in this video I'm gonna show you how to use Oracle VirtualBox and how to create a virtual machine. We have our physical machine in a Ubuntu, and in this video we are also creating a Ubuntu virtual machine. So first of all, search for VirtualBox Manager, and if you want to know how to install VirtualBox in a Ubuntu, on a description you can check a link. So let's start and see how to create a virtual machine. Click on New, type the name whatever you want, select the type of machine. Right now we are creating a Linux, but as you can see there are lots of options available over here, like Microsoft Windows, Solaris, IBM, Mac, etc. So just select Linux, and here you can select a type of Linux. As of now we are selecting Ubuntu 64-bit. Click on Next. You can adjust memory whatever you want. In this physical machine we have 12 GB of RAM, and for a VM we are setting 6 GB, and here it is asking for type of hard drive. We are creating a virtual hard drive and it is recommended. Click on VDI. By default it will select a dynamic allocated. Click on Next. Here you can select a hard drive size. Currently I need around 150 GB space in a virtual machine. Click on Create. Now you have already done all the basic settings. Now click on Start. It is asking for boot media. Before starting this video recording, I have already downloaded a setup of ISO file of Ubuntu 18.4. This is the official website of Ubuntu. You can download it from here. And let's go to VMbox, and you can see it is asking for a boot media. Go to the downloads or whatever the location, you can select. Click on Start. Now Ubuntu is loading. Now VMbox is installing Ubuntu 18.4. Just wait for the completion. This is the first screen. There are two options. First is try. If you click on try, it will show you a basic option and operations of Ubuntu. And if you want to install, just click on install Ubuntu. Now it will ask for a keyboard layout. Just select English US. Click on continue. Click on normal installation. One more thing you can do, just uncheck this, because it will take lots of time while installation. You can select erase drive and install Ubuntu. Click on continue. Select your region. Enter the name. Enter the password. Click on continue. So installation is done. Now it's showing that installation is completed. You need to restart the computer in order to use a new installation. So we are going to just click on restart now. So we are just going to log in. So our fresh Ubuntu installation has been done.